We just took apart the most repairable smartwatch on the market, and it's made by a company that you'd never suspect. Google's Pixel Watch 4 is totally redesigned, now more repairable than ever, and I can't wait to show you how they did it. Before we get into it, full disclosure, iFixit does have an existing business partnership with Google that is completely unrelated to this teardown, but it goes without saying, we're completely biased towards repairable products. After playing with the remote camera app to snap a sneaky picture of myself, I slide the wrist straps off using the same quick release buttons we've seen before. So far, it's familiar territory. But right away, there's something new, visible screws. Even better, these screws don't compromise water resistance. Each screw is fitted with a tiny O-ring that helps seal the watch. These are how Google managed to keep an impressive IP rating while still allowing for access. I'm gonna grab my 2IP Torx Plus driver, and actually, I'll only need 1IP, 2IP, and 5IP bits, plus a spudger and tweezers for this entire teardown. With the two outer screws dispatched, I can lift up the rear sensor glass, which is connected to the main board with a small ZIF connector. Now here's something fun, those exterior screws we just removed actually operate a hinge mechanism. When tightened, two tiny arms reach up, grab the plate, and pull it down and outward, compressing a seal that sits on the outer edge of the sensor. It's very slick and totally new. This whole opening procedure has been a breeze so far. On the Apple Watch Ultra, screws on the back teased us, but you couldn't actually do any repairs via that back panel. Here on the Pixel Watch 4, we're finally seeing a real rear entry design, a total rethink of smartwatch architecture. That's an enormous improvement for both safety and convenience. Under the plate, we spot the vibration motor, which is now held in with screws and connects via pogo pins instead of a fragile flex cable. And there's a creative reduction in screw complexity here. Two of those vibration motor screws double as battery screws. After removing two more Torx screws and a single press connector, the battery is free. No heat, no glue, no drama. This little metal encased cell clocks in at 1.747 watt hours, a nice upgrade from the Pixel Watch 2's 1.184 watt hours. Next up, the screen. It's also screw secured and, drumroll please, sealed with an O-ring gasket. That gasket is a big deal. It's replaceable, it's available for sale, and it's one way traditional dive watches have kept their water resistance for decades. Gaskets can be a tricky proposition for square smartwatches, but by making this thing circular, Google has achieved an IP68 rating without gluing the screen. Just the gasket and screws, simple and effective. We're left with the case and the system on chip, and just like everything else, removing it couldn't be easier. I'll break out my reflow station to deshield this board to see the chips underneath. On the board we have Qualcomm Snapdragon W5 Plus Gen 2 quad-core processor layered under Biwin's multi-chip package containing 2GB of LPDDR4X and 32GB NAND flash. Everything about this teardown screams designed for service. Google says they'll publish a full service manual at launch, everything but schematics, and we expect them to sell replacement screens and batteries. Bands, of course, are already widely available. And once again, this thing is totally redesigned inside while keeping the same exterior look. It's a brand new architecture under the same shell. By the end of this teardown, I've got to hand it to Google, this watch earns its provisional 9 out of 10 on repairability. Screw-based construction, no adhesive, accessible battery, replaceable gasket, and a full manual on the way. Honestly, this is the most satisfying smartwatch teardown I've ever done. No heat mats, no shattered glass, no hidden traps, just the thoughtful design that seems built to be repaired.